This is the Anki Cosmo. So coming in from Anki is a bit of a smart robot-y type affair. And it's actually a much smaller box than I had anticipated. Right, okay, so that's it there. And some press information. This is a robot that interacts with you and does stuff. Thankfully, as opposed to being a robot that doesn't do anything. That seems to be a bit useless. He's a cute little critter that has two eyes here and can push stuff around, runs around on some tracks, and learns a bit from you. It's got some artificial intelligence and a camera in here so it can interact with you. You can talk to it, it'll respond and have emotional exchanges with you via its eyes. Okay, so there's some blurb if you would care to read through that. A bit like Star Wars flowing through here. It obviously has an app that's compatible with Apple, Google Play, and you can Amazon App Store as well. So compatible with Kindle, I'm guessing. It's got a Qualcomm inside it. And it's cloud connected, voice activated, made to interact with people. Helps out and hangs out and helps out, hopefully does the vacuuming, explores the world and learns new things. Included in this is the Vector robot, a cube and the charger. I'm guessing the cube is a bit of a toy that it plays with, much like in Terrahawks. So we're going to pop it open, set it in to its charger and get it going. It's one of those boxes. Okay, right. So la di da. Sensible packaging. We'll start with this because it's closest. This is one of the blocks. It looks like it takes a battery of some description and has, well, some stuff on it. There's things over here. I don't know what it's actually supposed to do, but yeah. Okay, and then under here we have a charger thing. Okay, we'll go with something else instead. This is him. I actually thought from the imagery that he was a bit bigger, but we'll have a look around him in a second. And that's how we pull that out. So we've got the charge bay there that he parks in, a bit like a Roomba. It's charged by USB. Okay, we'll leave that over there. Wonder if it'll do stuff eventually. That's a little round disc of foam. We have an instruction manual to the side here, with Vector product information guide and a quick start guide. And a bag of silica. That's it. That's your lot. So, this is our guy. There's two little pogo plugs there, which obviously connect here to charge. These are the trucks that allow him to drive around. Probably aren't supposed to do that whilst he's not on. That's his little face in there, which... And you can see the camera in below that. There's a wee round cutout for the camera. And then there's this as well, which he uses to pick up the block. And there's speakers, I think, and something else here. And if we put that there, we get a green light. And there's a blue light there. So he's lacking battery power. I'll leave him charging for a wee half hour and come back to him later on and see what he's doing. Okay, so we're pretty much charged. It's green now as opposed to blue. It's still flashing that charging is happening, but We're going to go ahead anyway because I'm too excited about getting this up and running. Okay, so we have to download the app, which is called Vector Robot from Anki Inc. It's got 3.3 stars after 388 reviews. It's had 10,000 downloads. Does that mean they've sold 10,000 of these, or are people just downloading the app to be nosy? Vector's home robot who's alive, aware, voice-enabled, eager to help. Okay, Vector right now is okay. The app is a problem. It crashes and freezes on maybe some lesser devices. Okay, so some people are having problems with the app. We'll see how we do. Let's get that installed. Okay, so this thing has a personality, and apparently it's a wee bit coy when it first comes alive, so I'm interested to see how this actually works. I don't think it's going to do tricks straight out of the box, but you never know. Just to get people into it, it might start doing that sort of thing. And we're going to throw that in there as well, just for giggles. Okay, so welcome. It's official. Let's go. Okay, we're going to go with UK English. Place Vector on charger. Oh, we have to sign up for an account. And we've done that, so we're just collecting anonymous usage. Create your Anki account. Keep me informed of all things Anki. Creating accounts. Activating account. Your account is now active. Okay, so it's searching for Vector. And we're right beside each other, so hopefully it won't take too long. It does say it uses Wi-Fi, so it'll obviously pass the Wi-Fi details over to the Vector robot. And I'm guessing there isn't anything I have to press on the Vector. It's taking its time. So much so, I'm getting bored. Bored. So while that's taken a very long time to do it, here's some of the specifications. We have an HD camera, an infrared laser sensor, a power button, a capacitive touch sensor, and beam-forming 4-microphone array. Mm-hmm. Okay, after hitting get help, it decided to ask me if it can use the Bluetooth. I said yes. Oh, right. Yes, N8U7, connect. Vector needs to pair your device via Bluetooth. To start pairing, place Vector on charger and then quickly click the button on top twice. Ooh, there's a key. Okay, we have to confirm the code. Code confirmed. Find networks. We'll go with that one. Oh, for goodness sake. And we're now on my local Wi-Fi. So it's got updates to do. Boom, 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 boom. Meet Vector. He's happy. Blah, blah, blah. While that's doing that, doing the upload, I'm going to entertain you all by pulling this little piece of plastic out. It lit up. Did you enjoy it? Evidently this is going to take 3 minutes and 50 seconds to do that. Okay, so we're getting to the end here, and it's restarting the Vector after downloading and installing some updates. And it's connecting now. Da-de-da, bum-ba-bum. Okay, so we now have a connection with the NB thing, so we're going to try and connect to it and see what happens. We've got V, and we've got a V on the front. So with any luck, aha, preferences. Vector's location city is incredibly wrong. We'll change that to, I wonder how advanced this gets. Bangor. There we are at the top. North Down. right. So we want to go with Celsius, because it's correct. Inches, yep. No, I prefer centimeters, I know, yes. And we'll go with 24-hour clock. And continue. Right, and it's found the cube. Thankfully, we've already pulled the tab out, as I entertained you with earlier. We have connected to the cloud as well, and we're ready to go, I believe. Vector is now registered with your Anki account. To connect to Vector from another device, download the Vector app and log in using your Anki account. Okay, so we hit continue. Vector is now ready. Wake up, tap, start, and look at Vector. Hey, Vector. Okay, so it's giving us some tips here as to how to interact with them. Come here. Come here. Okay, so he will make a sound and his backlights will turn blue. They're not blue. While his lights are on, say, come here. If you speak softly, raise the volume of your voice. Instead of saying, hey, Vector, come here. Hey, Vector. My name is Gareth.
Gareth.
That's right. Yes. Okay, so I'm going through some of the tips and tricks that it's suggesting in the app. Hey Vector, go and find your cube. Hey Vector, pick up your cube. Pick up your cube. He's looking at me. Maybe it's just not on or something like that. Maybe I have to... Is there a way to turn it on? There's no buttons or anything on this. Hey Vector, do a wheel stand. Hey Vector, give me a fist bump. Hey Vector, give me a fist bump. So looking through the application, we can do a few things, like we can play backjack with it, we can give me a fist bump. There's cube tricks that I couldn't get it to do quite right away. Dance to the beat. Uh-oh, he's going close to the edge of the table. But apparently that's what they do, they explore, they get to know their surroundings and things. Hey Vector, start exploring. Hey Vector, pick up your cube. Hey Vector, go to sleep. Go to sleep. Oh, and he just switches off just like that. Okay, well, there's a lot to learn here. There's a lot to be going through. There's all kinds of commands and things that are built into the app that we're not going to be able to get to go through right now. Also, I'm not entirely sure how much you can bombard them with requests and tasks, because they've injected a bit of a personality. He can fall out with you and things like that. He can become a little bit annoyed with you, and I'm a bit annoyed that I can't get him to pick up the cube, something simple like that. But we're going to throw this out to Peter for him to review. Hopefully he can have more luck with it than I can. Obviously he's going to try it a little longer than 2 or 3 minutes, but if you have any questions or anything you want him to look at in particular, let me know in the comments box down below, within reason. Hit that subscribe button and give us a wee thumbs up if you fancy. And other than that, take care.